In the two sutras, 19th and 20th sutras, the class of yogis and the class of attainment of the yoga state and the sadhakas were discussed and beautifully expounded and explained by Maharshi Patanjali. The 19th sutra of the Yoga Darshana Samadhipada is Bhavapratyayo Videha Prakritilayanam. Bhavapratyayo Videha Prakritilayanam. The 18th sutra we found the word Virama Pratyaya, and here the word is Bhavapratyaya. This word Pratyaya in Patanjali Yoga Sutra, a very unique word, specially used by Maharshi Patanjali, symbolizing, pointing to the meaning of an experience at a particular moment, or an object, an experience of an object. We find this word Pratyaya in the Samadhipada Sutra 10, 18 and 19. Similarly, the word Pratyaya is found in second pada, Sadhana Pada Sutra number 20, and in third pada, Vibhuti Pada, we find the same word Pratyaya is used in Sutra number 2nd, 12, 17, 19 and 35. We also find the word Pratyaya again used in the 4th chapter, Kaivalya Pada, in Sutra number 27. In all these places, the word signifies a specific meaning, conveying a particular experience and the object of meditation. And here, the word comes after Bhava Pratyaya. Bhava is a word which comes out of Bhu, means becoming. Basically, Bhava means birth, being, becoming, being born. So, Bhavasagara, Bhavatarini, Bhavaroga. So, Bhava is the life, the samsara. All the functions, experiences, relations, and all the activities together is conceived in this particular word called as Bhava. Bhava Pratyaya, and other word used is Videha. Videha is bodiless, no deha, bodiless. Generally, in our tradition, belief and culture, Videha refers to gods, goddesses, and Videha Mukti also is commonly used. So, Bhava is the samsara, Pratyaya is the cause and experience, Videha is the bodiless, Prakriti Laya, absorbed in Prakriti, merged in Prakriti. So the sutra meaning is, completes with Anam, that is Prakriti Layanam. That is a grammatical word, anam, which means of. So the rough translation is that for videhas and prakriti layas, birth is the cause. for the yogis of the two types, as it is a classification, and the kinds of the samadhi, and who have attained it, the yogis. Two kinds have been taken up here for videhas, bodiless. It is to be conceived and understood that whom we call generally as the gods, the powers of the nature. And videha also can be taken as no body consciousness. And bodilessness. That means this particular sutra also hints, a lurking hint, an important hint suggests that in this life, in this bhava, we can become videhas. Prakriti laya is generally taken as merging into the prakriti, that is unfulfilled commitments. So the samadhi, the attainment of the samadhi and the experience of the samadhi differs into, one is by birth and other is attained, experienced and achieved to a normal path of efforts. But Swami Vivekananda says both these are imperfect. Bhava pratyaya is a pratyaya, experienced, caused by bhava. Samadhi or yoga sthiti, reached, attained, experienced just by being born, by birth. We have great examples, special and extraordinary examples like Jadabharata. By birth, unconcerned. There are people in this world, in our own day-to-day relationships, day-to-day experiences, we come across people who have less and less body consciousness. People like Jadabharatas. And Prakriti Laya is people who have suppressed, unable to overcome in their own commitments, unfulfilled commitments. And they are also born again for the completion of that unfulfilled commitments. So the samadhi and the experience which is attained, reached, experienced by this, one is the by birth, by born, and the other is the by making an efforts. So both are being used or suggested by this. So this of two descriptions brought about by the objective existence, that is the bhava pratyaya, and brought about by the practice of the means. And in the case of the yogis, it is brought about by the practice of the means. And in the case of the videhas and prakriti layas, it is caused by birth, by bhava. And this is how the word and the sutra is hinting the class of yogis and the class of sadhakas and the kinds of yogis and the sadhakas and the kinds and the class of the samadhi attained. So basically the sutra deals with the two types, two classes of samadhi experience and classes of the yogis and the sadhakas. So bhava pratyayo videha prakriti layanam. Bhava pratyayo videha prakriti layanam. And the other's experience of the samadhi, which is to be experienced, which is experienced by a systematic approach and effort, that is the next sutra goes into it. Let us see the 20 sutra. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.